We've talked about how the most common type of trig integral involves powers of sine times powers of cosine. Well, the second most common is products of secants times powers of tangents. So in other words, something of the form secant to the n times tangent to the m, integrate that dx. So as before, we have four cases. And our first case is the case n equals 2. So in each case, I'm going to do an example. So when n equals 2, you use the fact that the derivative of tangent of x is secant squared of x dx. So you do a u substitution where u is tangent of x, and secant squared of x dx is du. So here's our du, and here's our u to the fifth. And so this is just the integral of u to the fifth du. That's u to the 6th over 6 plus a constant. And so that's tangent to the 6th of x over 6 plus a constant. Straightforward. Okay. The next case is when n isn't 2, but is even. So if n is even, we can convert secants to tangents using the formula secant squared equals 1 plus tangent squared. So if you had the integral of secant to the fourth times tangent to the fifth dx, you keep two secants to go with the dx. The other two secants you rewrite in terms of tangents. Then you multiply by tangent to the fifth of x dx. And then you do the u substitution, u equals tangent of x. And this becomes the integral of 1 plus u squared times u to the fifth du. So that's the integral of u to the fifth plus u to the seventh du is u to the sixth over 6 plus u to the eighth over 8 plus a constant. So that's tangent to the sixth of x over 6 plus tangent to the eighth of x over 8 plus a constant. Okay. It's philosophically the same idea as we used when we were talking about odd numbers of powers of cosine. You convert all but one of the cosines to sines, and then you go forwards. Here you convert all but two of the secants to tangents, and then you go forward. The one special case is when n is zero. If n is zero, you have to convert a couple of tangents back to secants. So in this case, you write this is tangent of x times secant squared of x minus 1. So this becomes the integral of tangent of x secant squared of x dx minus the integral of tangent of x dx. This is the kind of integral we know how to do. It gives us tangent squared of x over 2. And this is a basic trig function. It gives us the natural log of the cosine of x minus the natural log, but then we have minus that integral plus a constant. Okay, the third case is when m equals 1. Now here, what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to do u substitution where u is the secant of x instead of the tangent of x. And the derivative of the secant is the secant of x times the tangent of x. So that one tangent is part of du, but one of the secants becomes part of du as well. So this becomes the integral of u squared du. Two of the secants are u squared. The third secant is part of du. And that gives us u cubed over 3 plus a constant. And so that's secant cubed of x over 3 plus a constant. The fourth case is where m is odd, like secant cubed, tangent cubed. Well, we want to have one tangent, but we've got three tangents. So we get rid of them using the identity tangent squared of x equals secant squared of x minus 1. So we rewrite this as the integral of secant cubed of x times secant squared of x minus 1 times tangent of x dx. That becomes the integral of u squared times u squared minus 1 du, where u is secant of x. Okay, that's the integral of u to the fourth minus u squared du. That's u to the fifth over 5 minus u cubed over 3 plus a constant. So that's secant to the fifth of x over 5 minus secant cubed of x over 3 plus a constant. Finally, you look at a survey and say, hey, if n equals even, we've got our technique where we let u equal tangent of x. If m equals odd, we have our technique where we let u equal secant of x. If n is even and m is odd, then you get a choice. You can use whichever method you prefer. They both will work. If n is odd and m is even, neither method will work. There are more sophisticated methods that will work, but that's not the subject of this video.